Yeah, this is our Nissan 370 from Fast Five. You know, basically since Tokyo Drift, the Fast and Furious series veered into the muscle car realm. So I always try to bring back some imports just to stay true to the original Fast and Furious concept, which was a bunch of import racers in Fast and Furious 1. And this car, like I say, I think fits it perfectly. Fast and Furious 1 was about guys that were, you know, building basically economy import race cars and making, you know, super wild street machines out of them. And this fits into that category, I believe. You know, it's not like a GTR that's a ton of money. It's, you know, close to GTR performance, maybe not, but, you know, still a fun car at a very reasonable price. Once again, these cars work so well, there's not a lot mechanically I need to do to them. We install basically a Detroit locker, the body kit, like the fake supercharger on the charger. We have our fake intercooler in the front, seats, belts, wheels, tires, you know, make it look as great as possible. And that's about it. It's probably one of my most maintenance-free pitcher cars. It just, they always start, they always run, and always fun to drive.
So, first quarter, feels just totally stock. Actually, you know what? Now I'm thinking of it, it feels a little heavier than normal. And I think we have some extra weight in the back with those nitrous tanks. This may be one of the quietest cars on the movie set. No V8, no open headers. I think this is the one we take home. Transmission is surprisingly unmolested. It feels pretty fine to me. Clutch is good. But it does, no stability control.